What's up, monkey people? It's Monkey Poppins coming at you with Fat Thor and Phoenix Saga MCU, the last 10 years of figures. I love this series. I know it's a little bit more expensive, but the work that they put into it is phenomenal. It changes it out. Do you see it? And the Fat Thor with Stormbreaker, Mjolnir with some lightning effects. It's badass, right? I mean, what we can see about it is Fat Thor as a Viking. So, let's open this bad boy up. All right, here we go. We got this bad boy open. I like it. I'm a favorite. I've always had that part where whenever I see that Viking favorite, the beard, the fatness, and the chubby cheeks, I think of that part in Endgame where he says, "I knew it." I love when Chris Evans picks up the hammer and just goes to town on Thanos. But alright, let's get into this bad boy. He's not one but two. Lightning effects. It could be put on the hammer, Stormbreaker, or his hand. So, I guess he could be Emperor Palpatine with this. If you want, I mean, if you want to break into all Marvel and Star Wars, you could do that. That's awesome. But it does come with the extra set of hands. I don't know if you can see it, but if you ever seen Lion, it's like the claw. He has a set of hands like that. So I guess he could do a Palpatine. But here it is. This is some pretty good. If you could check that detail out, it has some silver between the roots. Painted silver, it's awesome. Has a blue effect, so it's all lightening up, like in the movie, when he does amazing things with this thing. I never understood when Thanos was beating him down, and he called for Stormbreaker, and came, and Thanos grabbed it, and went to chop him in the chest. How did Thanos pick it up or move it? Because once he grabbed it, the children's dead. But, plot hole, I guess. Here is Mjolnir. You check that out with the lightning effect. I don't know if you can see it, but it's awesome. I like it. It's a instead of basic silver, you have that blue hammer, so it has the lightning course into it. It gives it a little bit more uniqueness. That's how I talk about this figure. If you think this will have an eye crunch, nope. He has that beer belly, so he can't have an eye crunch. But it just has the double jointed knees, double jointed elbows, has a, I don't know what you would call it, but a T-twist. So you twist him right below his main boobies. So I guess it has that. I like the cape. It has that two-tone cape. It is plastic. I would like to a cloth or soft rubber for the cape. I don't know if it will hinder his ability. No, not really. He's not really heavy, but I would like the cape for the price. It's almost getting to the same price as NECA. So, if you're going to start charging us that NECA price, Hasbro, we need to get some cloth capes up in this mofo. Right? You would be on that one? So, Oh, no, it's a great figure. I like it. I love the accessories. I love the whole Infinity Saga, what they're doing. I can't wait to see what other characters they decide to release. If I had to pick one, I would say, give me Fat Thor with the green sweatpants, no shirt. When Rocket says, "You look like melted ice," I would love that. That'd be great. So, I'm gonna give this bad boy 8.5 out of 10. I like it. One of my favorite figures yet. What do you guys think? What would you rate this? What do you think about it? I wanted to know. Tell me all about it. Comment below. Check out the links below. Facebook, Instagram, everything. And shout out to Pro Level Gaming Wear. They sponsor us. Use the code MONKEYPAW10 to get 10% off all your purchases on the website. We love them. So, until next time, guys, tell me what you think. I can't wait to hear from you. Happy connecting.